what I want to do first. I want to make sure that I create a vase because I have to place my flowers in it. So let's see, we have the vase, usually, or maybe, you know what, maybe we'll push it on the side. So I like to have a vase here, and then with the colors, interesting colors, actually I'll make it like this, okay? I will work with heavy, heavy texture. So what I want to have beautiful flowers. I want to have one of the tulips coming here like this, you see? It will be quite a small vase, but it's okay. Then I want to have a beautiful big flower coming here, and then I would like to have another flower coming here, like you see, like this, crossing my edges of my masking tape. And I want to have a leaf here. I want to have some patterns. Maybe the flower even will come. Actually, I'm looking here for the different shapes, right? So what else can I have? I probably will need the table, the surface of the table here. Flowers would be okay, and maybe another flower coming again over the edges. It's always good, right? So we have all those strange flowers happening here. Good. Now, and actually even here. Okay, and then the shadow will come there. Okay, so I will start with the color of the background. And I will apply a little bit. Which color can we use? I will apply a tiny bit of my purple. So you see, this purple is good, but it's a little bit too dark. So what I will need to mix my purple with some of the white, right? See, and I use palette knife. I love palette knives, okay? So you don't need to apply heavy, heavy layer of paints, but you need to create the special strokes using palette knife, okay? So like this, okay, voila. That's really will look good. And it's not, this is not just one color. There's a little bit green mixed into it, and I really like the effect. Okay, like this. See, like this. We have this loose way of working. Okay, like this. Very much we are coming here, right, with the paint. Then we'll get the paint certainly here, and still a little bit more on the other side. Very nice. Well, I like it. Good. Then I want to bring a little bit of it here. Okay, like this. So we will have the one flower, another flower. Maybe, you see, it's easier for me later to cover this with another color. And it's, again, I'm not applying a huge amount of paint. Instead of later, go and find out this color. So it will be the stand here, but I'm also with the stand, I certainly don't want to have a huge contrast here. I want that all the contrast goes to the flower, right? Because they will be the focal point of my painting. Certainly here, you see, a little bit more of it here, like this. I like the combination. I like a little bit of this greenish yellow color mixed into my background with the purple. It just changes the purple, makes it looking more interesting, okay? So we have the vase, we have this, okay. So now, the next step would be to think about the colors of the flowers. And I think when we can bring some of the pink and red, that would be good. I can still think about the table, but I'm not so worried right now about it. So you see, I'm going almost with a pure red color for now. Okay, I just want to have some of it, some of those colors applied here, and just, I want to check how the colors will work together. So you see this pink actually, this red works quite well with my purple. Okay, right now like this. And then I will bring some other strokes into it. And what I will do, I will bring a little bit of a darker red into it. Right, I mix a little bit of the black. I also can mix a little bit of the blue into it because I don't want to have one monolithic color combination here. Okay, so you can see it for sure here. And then I bring this big pattern back on the top here. See, applying a little bit heavier paint like this. Okay, and that will be okay for now. Or maybe I still bring some of the orangey color. Little bit of it here. See, having fun. Good. Now from there, I want to, let me see, still here. I want to have another color combination, and I'm thinking this flower, maybe about the green. So I will look here for my, I have those strange greens here, and I will think about my leaf here. So my leaf has to really have this nice angular form. See, like this. I like to make it this way. See, I bring it here, I bring the vein somewhere here, right? And tiny bit of blue will come on it as well. So it's not one flat color, even a little bit of the purple on it, okay? So this will be good. I will maybe use right away this color to bring some of those stems. So you see, like this, bringing some of the stems of my flowers, because I don't know yet how I will 100% develop it, but this will not bother. Like those, the feet are the direction of your flowers here, and I think this will be okay. Now, the next step will be to think maybe with a little bit of yellow to come on this leaf. Right. Then what we want to have, you see some of the colors. Then you want to think about the position of the base. What do we do with the base? Which colors can we have? Everything depends, of course, which colors will you be using on our flowers. So when this flower will get a little bit more of the pinkish color, then I will need to think about, okay, what I can have here. Not too strong orange color, I don't think so. See, I just want to place it here as a shape for now, and then I will think about developing the separate petals here. So you see, here I'm taking a little bit of white into it, and I'm bringing this beautiful white color with some of my pink on the top here, you see, to create some of those beautiful patterns. But I don't want to, like you see, I don't have intention of developing my flower to perfection. I want that they will have a freedom here of acting. See, like this. See, a little bit. So right now are those colors, and I will come back, you see, thinking about how can I make it even more interesting, right? Like right now, I have approximately the shape. So I will think, let me see, and maybe moving it. See, actually I like the movement, like this, in this flower. Okay, then this one here, actually, why not to use the pink? I really like this pink color. So I will apply it here as a shape, peak shape. You see here playing. And I would go for the other one, like you see, really, really big. Coming even on the leaf, this actually it's a very good idea. Okay, like this, you can see it. Okay, like this, mingling with the other colors. I like this one here even a little bit more of it here. See, as a color. And then from there, I want to see some other colors here as well. But I have to think about the base. And for the vase, I can just simply right now use this white color that I have here. You see, a tiny bit of blue. You see, so this would be a good combination for me here. Okay? See, almost like the color of the color in the background. So here, that's my vase. For now. Okay, then I have to think about the color of the stand. And for the stand, I want to have a color that yellow ochre here. You see? So the yellow ochre, and I will mingle it with some other colors later on as well. But I think that will be a good combination here. See? Like this. And then I bring it on the other side as well. See? Like this. Yeah. Very good. You see here? There. Okay, I make it smaller, the base. I don't want to have it a really big one. And this will happen here. Okay, like this. Wow. See? And then we can start bringing some strange strokes into it. Good. See? Like this. We don't want to have one even color here, that's for sure. Okay. So I will apply some of the yellow. You see, I start playing with the colors here. See? Like this. Want to have fun. Okay, so I'm bringing this here. See, I'm having lots of fun. Good. Do I need to have such strong line here? I don't think so. I want to somehow mix those colors here on the bottom, you see? Like this. This will look really, really good. Okay? Okay, and then here. Fantastic. See? Really, really lots of fun. Oh, oh. Now, look at this. Now, from there, I want to look at this base still. See, because I want to emphasize it and make it a little bit darker on one side. Okay, so notice it's a beautiful play of colors. How we get them here? See, I'm not worried about being super precise again, but that's not my intention here. I still need to get the other flowers there. So, and for that purpose, I want to keep all those red colors here. Actually, I like this red very much in. So you see coming here, and again, I don't know where is it finished because of the masking tape, right? The masking tape drives me crazy here. Okay, this flower will be here. There, from there, we have to look at the combination here. So, you certainly will come with a little bit more, you see here, to bring our flowers, and we need this flower to come on the top of the other one, like this, okay? Then, I need this mingle of the green here between, you see? Very, very important, can't be just one color. See, like this, and we will know that something is going on there, like this. See, like this. Okay, then we can apply a little bit of the black here as well. See, and then the black will come here too. Okay, so you see, just a touch like this. Okay. So this is good. We still have to go with a tiny bit more of this black between here. I don't want to have it too much, but I need to have a little bit of it here. Okay? So as you can see, this is coming very nicely. You see, this flower has to have a little bit of the shape here. And I will use this pink again on the top. You see, to make the connection. Now, a little bit more of the white. So I'm using white here to add it to my flower and blend the colors, see? I don't want to have one color. You see, I can even go back to what was happening over there. So I can still bring some flowers here, a little bit stronger. This is a black dye, so you see, I'm playing with the colors. I really know that this will be open, and now I'm bringing some of the yellowish greens here. Okay. Now the last thing would be, let's see, I want to bring this yellow still here inside of this flower. See, like this, opening the flower, and I certainly need the same, a little bit of it here, you see, for my flower here. Right, this one would be okay, this one is okay on the bottom, so there's no problem, but I certainly need a little bit of this opening here. So you see, I'm really playing with the colors, and I want to have more of them, and I want to have heavier paint application. So you see, all of them really play together. So this beautiful purple, not purple, colors coming here on top of the black. See? And then this one is really working well here with all the colors that we have. And then I think we have to do something about, you see the stiff is too yellow here. We don't need it. Instead, we can bring a little bit of white onto it. Okay, so we will bring some of this color here and blend it onto it. You see, like very, very nice. Right, still, this is not perfect. So I still have to find out how to do it. And I'm just by applying, I'm trying to get it the way, again, that it will speak to me. A little bit darker underneath, okay. This is good here, what's going on. I think when we think about those flowers, we can have some, especially like you see in those sections, here we can have some of those strange colors coming here. Even there, like you see, really, really playing. And for sure, like you see, bringing really richness here, okay? Like really, really letting them play. Okay, that looks good. And I think we have to do something about this stand because the stand is boring. You see, I don't know. I don't like the stand at all. But now it's better a little bit. Yeah! So you see, it's always, always way to fix the problems. Okay, this will be better. We'll go like this. See? And we'll have a very, very happy painting. Ooh, that's so nice. See, be happy. Always, always, always. This is the trick. Happy, happy, happy. You see, like this. We place all these colors here just to make this painting really shine. Okay, and this is the idea. See here. For sure. See here. There. I really, really love to work with colors. Okay, and make them play with. See here, still a little bit more. Still a little bit more here. But notice what is happening. This whole painting becomes alive. And this is because we used lots of colors. And we let the also play with the texture here. So it's not just one thing. I still think I can go here a little bit, you can see more the colors, and will be in the second time to finish, to call it quit, you see? So I hope that you enjoyed this process with me, that you will be willing to work on your own now on similar project, having lots of fun. So have a good day and see you next time. Bye.